In this episode, I will show you how to repair the AHL module. The AHL module will control the headlight movement. This car is equipped with dynamic xenon. The dynamic xenon is a very cool option. The dynamic xenon will control the headlight movement from up and down like a normal car to the left and right. When you steer the car to the right, the headlight will go to the right. When you steer the car to the left, the headlight will move to the left. On newer generation, the AHL is integrated in the light module. On this car, the AHL is a separate control unit. On about 80% of this type of cars, this generation, the AHL won't work anymore. I will show you how easy it is to repair this module. Of course, everything it will be very easy to repair on these cars if you have access to information. If you have access to information and you have the knowledge, the sky is the limit. You can see here the AHL module won't respond. Everything is responding. I have one error, and that error is no communication possible with adaptive headlight beam throw adjustment. To access the AHL module on this BMW e60, e61, I will need to remove this plate from here, because the AHL module is behind the glove box. To remove this panel, I have first to remove this carpet. To do this, I will need to pull back, and this will going back, because here I have a screw. The screws are Phillips type. I have one screw here, one here, and three more here. You can see here this panel is not in its place. This panel, it will need to go in this position. I will put it on the right position on the end. To remove this panel, I need to push in front and after that down. I need to be careful on this mat. I need to unplug the light and take out the panel. And after that, you can see this is my AHL module. I need to unplug this module. Like so. I need to pull this tab and pull out the module. AHL module. And now with the module removed, I need to take out the electronic board from this case. This is the board, and if you are watching here, this here is the main supply part. The 12 volts enter through this side, and here we have a double diode. It's looking like a small transistor, but this is a double diode. Let me show you on the microscope. You can see it, this one. This is a double diode. If I take out the protecting film of this, we can see what type of diet is. You can see in here it's an A4S. If I try to measure this one, I am sure that this diode is opened. Zero, zero. I will need that double diode. Here I have a lot of modules. These modules are with problems or with water damage. I think I will. No, I think I'll use this one. This is a AKPM module, the module that controls the fuel pump, and this one have some water damage and it's perfect for what I need. This unit have almost the same type of processor like my module, and I need to have the same type of power supply. And I see here two transistors, but one of them I'm sure that will be my double diode. Yes, this is my part. You can see A4S. Perfect. And let's measure this. Six hundred fifty-five, and the other way I will need to have zero, zero, zero. Perfect. First thing, I will take out the good part, the good component from my donor piece. And this is the good part. Now I'll need to remove the bad part from here. And now I have removed the bad component. I need to clean now this. Now let me see if I have done a Good job. Good enough. This double diode is a little bit bigger than the old one, but this is not a problem. This is very good because this double diode is more powerful than the old one. And this small capacitor is a little bit off. It's okay. It's making a very good contact. And now I will mount this on the car. And the last piece. And everything is back together. And now let's check the work. Echo respond properly. And zero fault memories. The AHL is responding with no errors. You can see the headlights. The light is put to automatic. The green light is on. You can see the headlight. When you are not moving, the headlights will move only to the right on the car with the left steering wheel. When you try to pull out in traffic, you will blind the other car. And that's why the system won't work when the car is on hold. When the car is on hold, the headlights will move only to the right. To the left, they won't move. I hope you learned something new. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing. And till next time, you know the drill. Stay awesome. Bye now.